this is something that C9 did not want to give away last game. They banned it first phase, but now I guess the question is, do you still want your Ember for Ritsu and the AA for Teban? No, they go Veno, so they are going to mix it up. This may prompt a potential Alk ban in phase two, because he's probably the best Aghanim's recipient.
Venomancer?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Yeah. Absolutely.
Him or Necrophos, I think, has been amazing for monkey
business. I think Veno is incredibly awesome, especially when you... do you like... Actually, so I have a question.
I love this opening from Unknown. To me, this is like their bread and butter classic
opening.
Run at them, dominate the lanes, do not let you farm, gank you under your tower, kill you under your tower, take the tower. Like TI2 era Na'Vi style. That's how Unknown want to play, so... I think just more... It's not necessarily a better opening than what they had last game, but it's much more in their play style.
Do you like Venomancer better as a core or a support?
He needs to get farm. He needs to get an eggs. Well, so you either want him as, you know, your 2 position or 1.5 position Venno or whatever. Or you... You know I don't even like that hero.
I know. Yeah,
or you have him be played by a 4 position, like a greedy 4 position, like an AUI or something.
Okay.
Whenever you say the name Na'Vi, chat just starts giggling.
Na'Vi.
It's like when someone farts in middle school and everyone just all the like teenage boys just start laughing.
Did you just compare Na'Vi to a fart?
I said saying the name Na'Vi is saying the name Na'Vi.
He did.
Twitch chat is the Dota equivalent of a middle schooler farting in the class.
I'm telling you.
Yeah. So a fart is like a joke in middle school.
So Na'Vi is as important
the way
as
that
a
they react.
Joke.
So their reaction.
Their reaction.
So what you're saying is that Na'Vi is a middle school joke.
Yeah.
No, I'm saying that they are juvenile. That's what I'm saying. I'm a Na'Vi fan here. Okay. I'm defending Na'Vi. Okay. No. Who am I kidding? Na'Vi is a joke.
Wow. They banned Death Prophet. They banned Nyx. That's Brax played Death Prophet like all day yesterday. I think he played 2 or 3 games. Or won the day before or something, but he's played DP at least 3 times, and MSS has played Nyx quite a bit.
Ooh, I like this. This is very smart by C9.
The Storm ban.
The Storm ban. They Unknown bans Nyx. C9 counters with a Storm ban.
Yeah.
So they know that Unknown very likely want to play Storm. They've done it before. This is what it was their go to in their series against E-Wolves when they lost. So, very heads up.
I like
by,
this ban, yeah.
Very heads up by T-God.
Brax is going to get his TA this game, and he's been savage on TA. Like, I've seen a couple games, like, he just goes nuts.
Yeah, Unknown don't have the Shadow Fiend to go to either.
So, I am curious, is this going to be back to the solo mid Dark Kanoa quap, or do they run it safe lane again?
The Null Talisman dropping.
Yeah, quap. Shenanigans quap. It is a Radiant TA at the very least, so not quite as strong, but still a good hero.
Yeah, still pretty good.
You pull the Quap a Sentry so that you can't meld dodge the Shadow Strike here.
Even then, I think that's...
Generally, TA is going to farm.
Yeah, he's going to farm. I haven't seen that work very often. I don't even think you... I've seen people really do it anymore. You might do like Queen of Pain plus one to roam on
the
TA.
Sometimes
the
Nightstalker will roam and gank the lane. And they go into clock. Now, they quap a likely Orchid Carrier versus the Ember, but this is an offlaner. They cannot lock down Ember. Great against...
Is this? I don't even think this is that good
it's
against...
It's not even
TA.
That good against Venno or TA,
yeah,
honestly.
I'm not too much of a fan of clock here.
What else was available?
What you can do is you can hook onto the Venomancer and you can turn on Blade Mail. And,
you can maybe force him to Poison Nova when he's not able to hit multiple heroes, but he's... Venno's a hero that pretty much expects to die every fight anyway.
Yeah. He's like a walking R button, and my mission here is done. If I die, it's okay.
Yep.
Not preferred, but mission accomplished. Still got all of his damage done, basically. I also don't really like the clock here. I mean,
I think
you can still remnant out
I,
of batteries.
I understand
right?
their... It's
pretty much instant.
I understand their mentality behind the clock. I think Unknown just wants to run at you. Clock is a very... He can force fights. He can run at you. He can start things.
He makes fights happen even when you don't want to.
You know what Unknown might want is the Storm, because Cloud9...
He already got banned.
Oh, did he get banned? Sorry.
We talked about the Nyx Storm banned.
Apparently, I'm not paying attention.
Happens.
You're thinking about Na'Vi.
Yeah, you're too busy. Too busy dumping on Na'Vi, just figuring out the next way to insult them.
Oh, man.
God, this headset really does not fit my enormous head.
We all poke fun at Navi, but it's just because it's just depressing. Like, they were such an amazing like team to watch as a fan, and like the stories behind that team going back all the way to TI1, up until TI4, they were. You know, it's like when Michael Jordan came out of retirement for that one time too many, and he was just not the old MJ.
I think it's especially. I mean, Dendi is basically the poster boy of Dota 2, and now he is on like a tier, whatever team.
And I don't actually think they're all individually so washed up that they're incapable of performing better, but it's just the team just needs a shake up. So
I think I think there are a lot of issues outside the team.
I heard a lot of rumors that Havos was not going to be on Navi after TI, but I guess they never really came to fruition. But I wasn't surprised, just because I feel like they must need like a new environment or something. There has to be some kind of maybe it's not an underlying issue.
Ultimately, we're all just speculating. We're just speculating.
We don't know what's going on. But yeah. Wow. Okay, back to the draft. Wyvern is the grab here. Nice. Gets some great control for the Ember and the TA, a counter to the physical damage.
Right. I think this is really good. This has always been a really good hero against Cloud9. All of the games that they've lost against various teams, especially DC. DC has a winner. It's against a winner Wyvern. This hero is very good against the kind of playstyle that Cloud9 typically wants to go for.
They banned AA, but with C9, C9 banned Slark. To me, that kind of suggests they don't want the AA anyway, and it would give them a very low control lineup. I guess that would put Tusk as the offlane farmer, Venno AA support duo. Generally, when we see that support duo, they're very vulnerable to just mobility-based drafts.
I mean, MSS, I think, normally plays Slark in the off, or Tusk in the offlane, rather.
Yeah.
I don't think this is going to be...
SVG
does have a really good Tusk. Maybe not.
Savage plays Tusk.
That's true. And MSS played really well in like the more farming offlaner last game.
So I like the AA ban here. Venno AA is not something you really want to play in against, but I guess... all right, I don't... What's
offlane Alk?
That might be.
I think offlane Alk, they stack the Ancients for him, and he catches up later maybe. TA mid, Ember safe lane. Can they do their Ember offlane stuff that we saw? Then your Alk is.
You know what might be interesting? That this is support Alk, and he still goes Grievous Greed level 1, and he pulls mid a bottle.
That's an interesting play, actually. I like that. There you go, Charlie. Think outside the box.
Because MSS generally, I don't see him as a Tusk player. Maybe he's the. I actually don't. I have no idea.
I play Tusk at TI a lot.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Well, we'll see. Cloud9 obviously have something unorthodox.
I think that might just be a support alchemist.
It could be. Maybe he starts off support and transitions, kind of like the old like 4-position Naga back when there were. I know Alliance had a couple games with EGM transitioning into a carry. Let's see. Cloud9, waiting.
I'm waiting with mid. Like, I really want to know.
All right, support Venno. No surprise there. And now the big question. What is MSS? Mojo Storm Stout. What's he going to play? 10 seconds remaining. I think if it's not actually the offlane out from the start, I think he'll be put into a farming role eventually anyway. So.
That is a 1437 Alchemist.
All right. Alk's Acid Spray alone is a good enough spell that he's not useless as a support by any means. But, you know, you pick this hero, you really want to be taking advantage of Grievous Greed. I wonder if the... You know, one interesting thing when he's a support, he can afford to leave the lane whenever he wants to get the runes. So he maybe gets more bounty runes than a mid-Alk would.
Kind of an interesting lineup, though, from C9. I mean... We'll see how it works out. I don't hate it. I don't hate it, but I also...
I'm just very confused.
And I'm very skeptical, though, that this is going to work.
Pause. Question mark from Z-Talk. He's curious what's going on.
He's entering the zone.
Ritsu buys time for MSS.
He's weaving.
Some excellent banter.
All right. Well, MSS is in the game.
All right, big question for me is, will we see that dominant showing from Dark Kanoa? Because last time he played 1v1 mid, he absolutely wrecked Smash.
This could be a roaming Alk.
You go like the minus armor build.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Because yeah. The cool thing about support out, because you don't have to worry about missing CS in your lane.
So.
That's fine. You can stay on me, Rob.
I want to see what 1437 goes at level 1. Or how much gold does he have? Yeah, this is it. He wants to pull his middle bottle.
Okay. Interesting stuff.
Well, this is
actually the most annoying thing in pubs.
We've seen the bottle pooling not really work, though. So I'm curious to see if it actually pans out in a big competitive match.
It's still the most frustrating thing. Like
it is very aggravating.
If you're on the other team and you're doing really well against mid, you know he's low on regen, and all of a sudden his support just gives him a bottle. That's so demoralizing to see.
Well, Cloud9 did get a ward down on the high ground over here in mid, so they have very clear vision for the Alchemist. They know that there's no one here, so he should be able to get this rune with no problem. Clinks. I like clinks in this game, I think.
You know what? To counter that, what I would like to see is the Winter Wyvern camp the bottle and try and snipe the courier before.
I'm not sure if he necessarily realizes what's happening. And 1437 has spent more of his gold on a soul ring, so maybe not.
I guess it's not happening.
You know what it could be is some sort of like disgusting semi jungle alchemist where he just keeps on stacking camps and then gets the level 2 spray and goes in with the soul ring to clear it out. But now Ritsu in the river, they want the bounty room bottom. They're gonna grab it. Ryo may pay with his life. And Tusk grabs the top, but they do deny one to the Alchemist, who already skilled Acid Spray. So, first blood going the way of Cloud9.
Went to Brax.
Well, so much for needing to pull him a bottle.
Start out with a nice little advantage. He does have meld level 1 again. And wow, the Quap actually has Blink, so that's not a great way to start the lane.
Oh, that's really bad.
That makes this lane a lot harder.
Well, and good news, Brax did even take meld right away. So he is counting on being able to meld dodge the Shadow Strike.
Okay, well, that's not the worst thing anymore, but...
Not ideal, though. Yeah. In fact, Brax... Maybe it is the worst thing.
He has a sentry. Does he have a sentry?
No.
Yeah, he does. Two sentries.
Oh, he has one in his inventory, yeah.
Top lane, though, making their go on the Bone Fletcher. He's only level 1. Alk, no stun. Will be forced back, but they are going to dual lane the Clinks and just spam him.
This is a...
Very light on regen at the early levels.
This is really interesting. You just have your Alk throw Acid Spray. That's super annoying for a hero like Clinks. Doesn't have...
No duster detection, though.
And he's low on regen as well.
Yeah, normally, as a Clinks, you rush your Bassy, Soul Ring.
And then run into the enemy woods.
Yeah. Especially once you get level 6, you just often give the lane to a support and fully roam, but... You gotta get those basic regen items first to handle the lane. Still, despite Brax getting the first blood, Queen of Pain doing very well mid, as we would expect from Dark Canela. This guy definitely has the individual mechanics down. Is 8-4 to Brax's 6-0. They're making the move onto SVG. Ryo trying to engage. Yesterday we saw the Bulba clock, but Ryo not quite on point with those cogs. He will push SVG towards safety.
Do a void.
It's like one of those.
Good job fogging it.
He should just ultra it like dash ping right now. He is playing from Peru.
All right, so 1437, he's going to kill a creep here. No bounty rune. I was thinking if it's a bounty, he kills the creep, levels up greed, then gets it. Sentry deployed in the mid lane. This makes life a lot trickier for Brax. And he has not been given a sentry of his own.
This mid lane, I feel like... I don't know. I believe in Dark Canoa that he can win this lane.
Brax is doing pretty well, though.
You can only win so hard against the TA generally. Especially when she gets first blood like that. Bottle slowly limping back to base. They're also getting free farm on Ritsu. The offlane Tusk actually doing pretty well after the support 1437 provided. So early on, it looks like Cloud9's core is getting quite a bit out of this laning stage.
And ultimately, no matter how, like, even if Brax gets a little far behind, he's just going to go and do Ancients. It's a really easy way for
TA to shut up TA down, to be honest. And unlike an Alk, that's a hero that's very scary with relatively little farm.
Yeah, and Cloud9 is generally very good about stacking ancients and being very efficient with how Brax, you know, catches back up.
Well, they're going to make a play on Brax. He's rather far out in the mid lane. This is probably his downfall. Void comes out. They can get the Winter Wyvern Arctic Burn off. Gets one auto attack, but not enough. They're still diving for this. They want to commit onto Brax as a refraction suit. Turns with the side blades. Ouchie. And now top lane. They jumped the Clinks, but no detection yet.
I feel like he voided a little early.
Now Ryo being dove. Only the level 2 flame guard. Not that good for getting a kill. But yeah, Brax doing a good job here in the end, and Unknown not quite crisply executing that particular gank.
Up in top lane, the Klinks is getting a little bit better farm now. Wyvern is healing him up since he is mostly run out of regen.
It's a level 4 Tusk, and
they're not going to get
this. They're not killing him.
I think the Clink's going to be really powerful this game, though. I mean, if he gets an early Orchid, he can kill most of the heroes on C9.
Almost every Clink's goes Deso now. I was really surprised to see Loda get an Orchid the last game, honestly. And they're dire. I think they need the Deso.
That's
to
true.
Go
they might need the
Maybe
Deso
Medallion rush. First, depending on...
I think the Queen of Pain is going to be the one to get the Orchid.
And if you want to lock down Edmund Clinks, I'd rather see him go into like a late game Hex to deal with Ember than the Orchid, which is often countered just by a Manta pickup. But we shall see. Early days here in game number 2. For those just joining us, just getting home from work, Cloud9 currently leading in game 2, as well as having the one game advantage in the best of 3. Winner will move on to Frankfurt. Loser faces Digital Chaos immediately afterwards for a shot to advance. Ryo getting caught up bottom lane, tries for the TP. Should be able to make it back, but good pressure there from Ritsu and SVG teaming up to force him away.
Oh, there's a little bit of
they have detection yet?
Conflict going on in the jungle as well.
So, in good news for Unknown, there have been no stacks as of yet.
Brax is getting camp mid, and his CS is suffering.
Yeah, and he's not getting stacks either.
Yeah, Z-Talk is just camping him.
From the looks of things, are there any? There's nothing.
There's one stack, but it's
where
like
is it?
The
medium
one.
Camp.
Yeah, it's not very good though.
So they're shutting down the TA pretty damn hard. The Clinks is free farming up. Well,
they even
was free farming.
Oh god, they even sentried the ancients too. Like they're really trying to make sure Brass gets shut down.
Tusk didn't even have detection.
Yeah,
either.
That's a little weird.
He was pretty low when he was sticking around in the lane. They're getting a lot out of the Tusk pick. This, to me, this hero has consistently made big plays for any team that drafts him in the Americas.
I think getting him fourth, they got him fourth pick again. That seems, that just seems like way too much. That seems so good. I don't know.
Yeah, I agree. This, TA is a very comfort hero for Brax.
They're going to bring in the Alk mid lane, drops the acid, has gone for one point in the greed, and finally, Dust is out on Teban. But they have an Invis Stalker prowling about.
He's only level 3. I don't think he really has kill potential on really anybody on CNI.
They might be able to kill Alk. He's only got 2 armor.
Just got blocked. He should know that.
They get right on top of him. Night Stalker going to work. Hoshimiki doesn't even want to engage because Templar Assassin's in the neighborhood. So Z-Talk's going to wait. Ancient stacking attempted, but Brax will not be able to stack these due to the sentry.
He will be thwarted.
They're doing a great job of shutting down the TA. No, not allowing the stacking. Haven't given away any more kills since the first blood, but the trade is your free farm Ritsu Ember. As they roam on the top lane, mini stun for the Void. Enough with the Clinks to help get the kill. That gives some much needed experience the way of your Clinks, who's now level 6, is going Orchid Rush. Picks up the Oblivion Staff.
Wow, this is an extremely poor Wyvern. He has one sentry. Or one observer, rather. That's it. That's the entirety.
Oh, Clinks.
Dead. Dust it up. This game feels like it's going extremely well for Cloud9. Beyond the fact, except for the fact that Brax is getting camped a little bit, but I think the fact that Ritsu is farming so well makes up for it.
Yeah, he's going to be the big space maker here. But I think Clinks just needs to play a little more cautiously. He's sticking around a lane with very low health on a pretty regular basis. He can also go to the jungle if they want, maybe leave the Wyvern or even the Night Stalker top to catch up a bit. Clockwheel Bottle of Bounty, double damage rune, more importantly, picked up by your Queen of Pain. And Ritsu, what did he buy? Looks like drums? No, Akila.
I think this is going to be a pretty standard game for Ritsu. Going to get a Boots of Travel next. Get to Battle Fury. Maybe a Lincoln's after the Battle Fury, depending on how fast he gets his second item.
Against the Wyvern, that Lincoln's feels like a good choice.
And the Orchid against Klinks.
Oh, God. Is Ryo actually going to kill SVG?
Oh, yeah. He's dead.
Yeah, he looks to be dead. And meanwhile, in the top lane, also making the jump onto the Klinks. Committed dive here. He does not even bother.
Oh, they're going to get both of them.
And they're going to get a double kill. Last hit going the way of MSS.
Not
big rotations.
Good.
This is Dark Kanoa's moment. He needs to step up. There's no remnants available. He might get two.
Is he gonna get stunned? Oh, what?
Nothing.
What?
Oh, Dark
Why?
Kanoa.
What?
Panicked under the pressure.
I want to say he has to have like some delay here because that ulti came out like a good. Maybe half a second, full second after.
I think it was
after the snowball.
Yeah, he was like trying to time it the second that the snowball ends. Maybe worried the walrus punch would instantly get him killed together with another chains or auto attack from the two heroes before he's able to make a move. But they ball
They're
in again on the click.
They're
just praying on it with the walrus punch. Dust not even needed. MSS.
Yeah,
Klinks, making things happen.
Klinks, once he hit level 6, he should have just
battery out.
Wow, oh, that was
some
very
RNG
lucky.
Gaming from Braxton.
All right,
this game is crumbling.
They're
they
just
are
feeding
self-destructing.
Right now.
This game is just crumbling. They're tilting. Dark Kanoa missed his ult. They're diving. They don't kill Brax off of like some sick RNG.
Does Kotaro play too much Klinks? Because typically how EG has done it in the past is. Klinks hits level 6, goes into the jungle, eats a creep, plays in their jungle, and they apply a lot of pressure to their safe in mid lane.
I will find out for you.
Yeah, that's
Charlie.
What I was wondering, because I was really surprised to see him go back to top.
Yeah, he's just sitting there farming, but he's like such an easy kill for the Ember.
I mean, the hero's not an anti-mage. It's just not the idea of a Klinks to just sit there AFK farming.
This is just space. SVG's doing his best pilot eye impression.
He's never played Klinks before in an official.
And then... I mean, last game they put Ryo on the Quap as well, which clearly wasn't his comfort hero. I don't know, maybe getting away from their bread and butter, which got them this far.
I'm not a master at Dat Dota, but it appears that he has never played Klinks in official.
Oh, I believe you're a master, Greg.
I'm definitely not. Remember when you tried to get me that tiny IO stat? I required assistance.
And you like choked.
I choked, and then someone saved me anyway. Thank you, base stats people. But I don't know, man. This game feels like it's gonna just fall out of unknown's hands really quickly. And Klinks is actually going Orchid.
Brax diving a bit far bottom lane. Looks like he's gonna feed away a kill. With the dust now activated on the way out. That's an unnecessary kill, but I guess the big issue right now seems to be that nobody can or wants to lane top against this duo of Ember and Tusk. Level 8 and 9, respectively.
Yeah, and Ritsu is just continuing to get a ton of farm here. He almost has his bots. Wyvern's here, sapping XP.
No level 6 yet, though.
Yeah, he doesn't have Curse, so I don't think they can really catch...
Maybe the Tusk.
Yeah, they're going to get Tusk here, but Ritsu... Oh, he's actually coming back in. This seems questionable. He has a Remnant. He's out.
Alchemist with a haste, also sprinting forward.
Cloud9 had some good plays for a while, and then they just threw it away a bit.
That's
very sloppy.
Plummets. Yeah, game one felt a lot more polished for both teams, aside from that one really awkward engagement. Now the Night Stalker begins to move. No longer a measly old Daywalker,
stack.
And that is a stack.
Oh, Unknown puts an Obs Ward down. They're going to try to steal it.
Unknown have no way to steal this, though.
Well, maybe they'll just contest it when Brax goes to farm.
Yeah, they can fight the heroes, maybe, but you're fighting into Acid Spray, Venom Wards. I see them having a lot of trouble contesting this.
If Cloud9 really want to take the stack, they're going to take it. It's not going to... I don't think... I think you're absolutely right. They can't contest into Venom Wards.
Oh, Z-Talk off on his own again. Unknown, this has become a trend for them. Giving up picks one at a time. They will trade for the Venno, though. A one for one as the Wyvern hides in the trees. Brax running right by him. So they'll get the one obvious kill there on the Night Stalker.
That's okay. The Night Stalker created space. He drew a lot of heroes towards him, and he got the kill in the end.
Ember is cutting creeps bottom. Does have a remnant way back in the lane. It's going to get out now that he sees the TP coming in from the clockwork. But unfortunately, leaves his tower with 100 HP, so that will presumably be denied by the clockwork.
Orchid going to be an important item here for Unknown. With the way the game's going for Ember, your Night Stalker unlikely to get the jump on him if Ritsu reacts quickly. And this is one of the most talented up-and-coming mechanical players in the scene. So
he's in the zone.
I think that was MSS they were talking about, but they're both in the zone now.
Quaff's getting an orchid too. Both getting orchids.
Orchids everywhere.
I think I'm okay with Klinx's orchid simply because he's going to get it so much faster than the Queen of Pain.
Yeah, I agree.
Brax is going for the stack now. They've cleared out the Observer Ward that went down, so Unknown's acting without the information that they had earlier. Z-Talk again is going to be roaming forward here. Looks like he's trying to build a Midas, but we're already at 14 minutes and he is 1,000 gold away, so.
All right, this is a really rushed Orchid. No stop off for the Soul Ring.
I think you have to get Soul Ring.
No upgraded boots.
Oh, he's going to.
He's going to run out of mana really fast.
Well, he's got an Orchid.
He can't even Dark Pact and, like.
When you're using all your spells, though, you need more than the Orchid.
Yeah,
to sustain
your mono pool. He does. But
he has enough for one good Mago here, though. Can
hopefully for him, he gets a good pick.
As they wait on the high ground, Z-Talk in a decent position here. Gets out the urn. Winter's Curse is finally available. He had an opening there. The Queen of Pain comes through and 1437 turn against Brax will help break through the refraction, but the Night Stalker is the first man down. Now Ritsu with the counter initiation. Klinx going to work. Not doing too much damage here, though. And now he's also
bolus.
Trapped in the chains. He's going to end up going down. Quap forced to blink away. They probably lose the Wyvern as well. Ritsu feeling it. Moving forward. Clock. With the counterplay, does pop the blade mail. It's going to wear off before the snowball completes, and Bertsu comes back 3-for-2. About to be a 4-for-2. Somehow Braxton survived through this, gets his blink on the back of it. And that is why Cloud9 love the Ritsu Ember.
Yeah, he plays
and
that.
And the Brax
so
TA.
Well.
Those are
two trademark heroes.
The Queen of Pain alt hit nothing except for a refracted TA.
Yeah, and the Winter's Curse also didn't really do any damage because he had refraction the entire time, so.
I mean, Unknown can't take a fight like that. Klinx just simply doesn't have enough damage or attack speed. What needs to happen is they need to catch out the Ember or just one core hero farming out by themselves. Orchid him, blow him up, get out. But a scrappy fight like that, you're fighting into wards, you're fighting into
Acid Spray.
This poisonous...
Poison ass.
I mean,
it's not that far.
Yeah, pretty close. Venomancer alt, and it's just. Imagine Queen of Pain blinks in, and he just gets Venno alted. He can't stay in that fight.
Oh no! They saw Dark Green, and they're running at him. They get the shards off. He's fairly tanky, courtesy of the Death Pact, and reinforcements arrive in the form of Ritsu. Down he goes. A cocky little play, trying to eat a creep, thinking he was protected, but I think they saw the fade there on the Windwalk, or the Skeleton Walk, rather, and gives up another kill. Unknown, showing perhaps their inexperience as a team. Though they've made runs in some online tournaments in the past. Never been on stage this big before.
They're chewing away at the mid lane tower and setting up some wards to make it hard for Unknown to defend it, but it looks like Cloud9 is going to back up. Oh. Quap is looking for something here. Has a haste rune in the jungle, but Sonic Wave is just coming off cooldown, and it's so hard to be able to kill the TA just because of refraction. So instead, heads toward the mid lane and will utilize her talents elsewhere.
A little surprised Night Stalker didn't go for the Midas.
Oh, yeah. He just ditched it. I guess he maybe he just decided it was
Z-Talk
just going to come
too
late.
I mean, clearly a very selfless player in general, and just their main, like, getting up in your face type of support initiator, but to me, this is a game where they're going to need that extra gold. You're up against Alchemist, Ember, TA. You're behind early. I don't think having upgraded treads really changes Night Stalker's impact in the upcoming fights, though We'll probably see the players immediately prove me wrong if the caster's curse continues. Yeah, I would have preferred the Midas on the Night Stalker for sure.
I just want to point out how poor the Klinks is.
This is... I mean, it's part of the issue with the Orca build as well. Like, really, all it's good for is killing. It gives you, yeah, some attacks being damaged, but, like, it pales in comparison to...
Odesso.
Solar Crest, or even just a Medallion or Odesso, obviously, for Roche, for Towers.
Ritsu is smartly deviating his build here. And, oh, Klinks is just dead again. He has no HP. He's walking around without Death Pact. I mean, I guess you want to be able to use it aggressively.
Klinks seems really lost.
Yeah, I feel like he has no idea what's going on in this game, to be honest.
Ritsu is getting Manta. Yeah, he's getting the preemptive Manta, which is very good.
I mean, against double Orchid, I guess you kind of have to. Bot lane, they're going in on Thieben. He does not have ulti and the blade mail. Looks like Thieben is going to fall here, but Ritsu's coming in.
He manages to buy his Blink Dagger before he dies.
That's actually a big deal. Tusk picking up a Blink Dagger as well, but now the Quap is here. Ritsu silenced up once. He might get silenced up again.
Oh!
But he gets pulled with the snowball! That's like the third time that's happened.
He must
Dark
be
Noah.
Lagging. That was so much time to cancel. And we've seen some big plays from Idol. I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt that he's lagging.
Man.
Ugh. Unknown. Falling apart here.
Brax is taking a lot of damage, though. And yeah, he's actually going to get cursed up. Are they going to be able to bring down Brax? Yes, they are. The Scream of Pain.
Still getting three heroes in the end, despite the Whiffed ultimate.
Should have been four.
Could have been the Ember as well. That hurts. Like, they get the Ember there as well. That is the game. Oh, they might still.
Eat the creep.
Eat the creep and Orchid. Quick. He gets it, but Ritsu into the trees with the TP out and gets fogged. Maybe should have waited for the rocket so he wouldn't lose vision. Missed opportunities abound here for Unknown.
This game feels rough for them. It feels like they don't really have any like objective. They're kind of just wandering around. Occasionally they get a kill or two, but then nothing happens. They don't push a tier one. They don't get any better map control. They don't set any wards down in the jungle. They just get a pick off and that's it. I don't know. It doesn't seem very effective. Where Cloud9... they're getting a ton of farm on Ritsu. They're pushing the lanes in. They've already taken down a bunch of tier ones. Have a lot more map control at this point in the game.
And good news, they did force Ember into a
suboptimal build.
Yeah, well,
I think he's okay
still
with
fine,
it.
Though.
Into
he's
a Manta. It slows your farm down a lot, though.
Yeah, but he's still fighting very effectively.
No Winter's Curse.
Oh, Klinks is dead again! Ritsu just stacked the remnants on him and killed him. Jesus, this Klinks cannot catch a break.
I can't even keep up.
He hasn't died yet, 7-0-7.
Ritsu is actually going insane this game.
This is the disaster Klinks game. No Midas, rushed Orchid.
Is
he has literally gotten 500 gold since the Orchid. It's been 7 minutes. He got it at 14 minutes.
And, I mean, Ritsu is so far ahead that the fact that he has to stop off for this Manta is much less of a big deal, you know?
Yeah, he doesn't want to... I think it's okay. He doesn't want to give away, you know, his giant bounty, all his net worth. He is the most farmed hero in the game right now, and he's just going to be a little safer. Perfectly fine.
So they are going to back off for a Midas, but it's the Wyvern Midas. Not the Night Stalker Midas.
I think this is okay for Unknown to win. This is going to have to go a little later, and Unknown is definitely going to need that refresher.
Oh, I agree completely. I just thought Nightstalker would also get one, but
the other problem with this game is now Brax has a Desolator, and looking at the HP of most of the dire heroes, they do not have very much.
Klinks has not had any item progression in the last
8 minutes. Yeah, he got the Orchid at 14.
Just buy gloves of haste right now.
He needs the whole team here to get kills.
And then Brax actually
might as well buy
away.
The gloves. He needs that extra attack speed. He farms so slow.
He needs a lot of things.
Klinks is gonna go for a pickoff on Brax, but Death Pact is running out shortly. He needs to do it soon. He's gonna do it now when Refraction is down. Brax trying to make it out of here, but he runs into the clockwork and they are gonna successfully execute the gank. On to Brax. Klinks has been tailing him for quite a while.
Much needed grab there.
He got a lot of money for that.
Ganon's on the TA, but you see the power of the TA. Yeah, she dies a few times, but unlike the Klinks, this is a hero that can just massively flash farm, clear stacks with ease, and still has quite a bit. Game's gonna slow down a little bit. Unknown now. Trailing 12-17. Still in striking distance on paper as far as the numbers go, but you look at Cloud9, they've got Greaval's Greed, they have a bonus Midas on the Venomancer. They have heroes that clear stacks, that flash farm Ember as well as TA. And with those,
this is the
higher damage output late game for sure.
This feels not like completely do or die, but they smoked a lot of heroes, and if they get nothing out of this gank, it's not a good look. That's even just getting 1437 doesn't seem very good.
That was a weird rocket. Alright, well, basically telegraphing the gank. 1437 will run up in the lane. The rest of the team pushing TA back to the Ancients.
Does have some help this time. 1437 is nearby in case he needs to bail out Brax. They have a sentry down as well, so no free initiations. Etok running in. Brax trying to get some damage off, but gets hookshotted. Blade mail. He's stuck inside with the clockwork. There goes the Winter's Curse as well. Looks like Unknown are going to get the better of the beginning of this fight, but
here
in the back, Toss is going nuts. And oh, he blew another ulti without hitting SVG, I think.
No, he hit SVG, but that was
just
it.
Just barely. God.
Man, 2-for-2. Ritsu uncontested in the fight now, chasing Hoshimiki. Doesn't quite have the Midas gold. That's going to delay it even further. Ends up being a 3-for-2.
Oh, lordy.
Sheesh.
That's the two cores down as well.
Yeah, and they're going to get a lot more map control off this. Do they have any wards that can plop in the jungle or anything like that?
Like, yeah, he hits.
Yeah, they do.
They need to be hitting multiple hero Queen of Pain ults with a multiple hero Winter's Curse at this point to take fights. If it comes down to these little skirmishes and man fights, TA is going to outman fight a Clinks who has this level of farm. And
Ember excels in these little skirmishes.
And Ember's just never getting controlled. He's just free to do whatever he wants. They can't lock him down by silencing him.
I don't really get how they don't have a better like stun or something for Ritsu when they picked it so early in the draft.
I think it would have been fine if they had a better laning stage, though. Like, if you get a fast Orchid on the Queen of Pain...
Nightstalker gets a little more. Yeah, there are ways you can control off.
I don't think their draft is terrible at dealing with Ember. I think Ritsu just had such a good start that now they're in a bind to control him. Yeah, there are better heroes to control Ember, but this is I'd say at least average or even above average draft, especially with the way they've itemized.
I think the Queen of Pain is just having a very unfun game.
Unknown. Good news for them is they'll have a second shot. Bad news for them is they may walk into the Digital Chaos match after a 2-0 beating.
On tilts, maybe not lagging
with the
a little.
Morale, yeah.
And DC did 2-0 them in the group stages. And there is something to be said about Unknown making adjustments, but DC is the team that gets to watch Unknown play this series.
Gold is starting to pile in now for C9, up to the 5k gold lead. And it definitely feels like all of their heroes will continue to be relevant, while your Venno, your Nightstalker could very quickly fall off if they don't continue finding kills. Now Cloud9 will smoke, but it was scouted by the Dire Squad. This could be an opportunity. They should have seen it. Ryo and Dark Kanoa in position. Clinks will go back for a Blink Dagger. Still no upgraded boots of any kind or an Aquila. Pure rat mode here from the Clinks.
I guess they think that's the only way they can win. Like, they can't really win by...
They saw the smoke. They have to expect that there's a rush going on.
They're just so slow.
He's going to go for
the
big plays here. Ryo could be the savior for the team. He wants it. Hooks on in. Aegis doesn't get it. Doesn't get the kill either. Unfortunate timing.
That's a lot of that is due to MSS just getting in a really good position to make sure he doesn't hook right into the center. Messes up the timing and... makes it so he's not able to get anything done. Just feeds away that life. Now they're going to lose a tier 2 tower as a result. Brax helping kill that extremely quickly. Looks like he's probably going to be going for a Mantis style of his own. Just getting these Mantis styles to help control against the Orchids makes a lot of sense. And he has a Desolator as well, so the Illusions will be hitting a little bit harder.
I think it's very rare that there's a game where you want more than one Orchid. That item just falls off so hard.
Yeah. Especially
unless
when
you're someone like Storm who can just constantly gank with ease at all times.
Cool Orchid, dude.
Yep, Orchiding out the Tusk. He might die to the Soul Burn. He's going to.
Oh, we were playing on the Orchid top. Damn it, Greg. Say what's going on, because there's an Orchid top as well.
he just casually Orchided the Ember. No real reason.
I thought you were talking about the Tusk, because he Orchided the Tusk and it looked like the Tusk was fine, but then he just died.
That's just really unfortunate, I
guess. Wait, which camera are the viewers watching?
Did he just hit him in...
He just Psyblade'd him.
while he was in Cold Embrace.
Psyblade is pure damage.
Yeah, you're right.
Wrecked.
That's a
Brax
that's
just
sick.
Absolutely wrecked the Winter Wyvern.
That's just a sick outplay, actually.
Yeah, that's actually crazy. Got him. I don't think I've ever seen that before. At least not like that intentional.
Braxton Dota.
Brax has been playing really well.
Your LGD International former member.
Hey, also a member of Summer's Rift. All
right.
Such
I mean,
established
I'm...
teams. Is this really what the Clinks has resorted to? Cliff jumping?
Looker's
hey,
here.
Hey, hey. Hey. Braxton, also a member of Navi USA.
He's going to get kit. No, Ebolas are in cooldown.
Well, that's imagine if he had died there while Cliff jungling. How depressing is that? Link, man. God damn it. Ritsu now has his bots back up and a remnant. He's going to go back and farm up top lane.
I like how we've gone from Ember at Starlighter 9 and RTZ getting like Vit
Ogre
boost
Club,
through
Vit Booster,
Ogre Booster Ghost Scepter, Ogre Club.
To Ember being in every game going, just going ham.
Are they going to get this kill? Nope. Nope. Ritsu is just too quick on that escape button.
Well, he has Manta. They need to silence him and then instantly silence him again as he Mantas, but then Ritsu could just hit his ultimate and he's out of there.
Yeah, it's really hard to make that timing work.
That's why I'm just not a fan of double Orchid. Like, one Orchid's okay, you can use it for a lot of other things, but this could be a Desolator. Clinks could have easily taken more towers, had more impact as he's just casually dropping his Orchid in the middle of the lane for basically just the hell of it. Oh no.
Quap is in the wrong place at the wrong time with Tusk backing her up. Backing up Ritsu. Well, I don't know, man. Feels like Unknown are just slamming their heads against the wall in this game.
It's feeling like a bunch of players are trying to individually win the team the game. Clink's running around desperately trying to make plays. We've seen the same from Dark Kanoa. Nightstalker just hasn't really been a factor since the laning stage, and I mean, at this point, it may be coming down to those big Winter's Curses to turn the game around.
Battle Fury now finally picked up for Ritsu. A little bit late, but due to that Manta. We've lost one of our co-casters.
Yeah, Charlie just rage quit the cast.
Yeah, this game was just too over for him to finish. No, no, that's not what happened.
I'm sure he had something very important and noble to do here, Greg.
Very important and, yeah. Whatever, Charlie.
Let's give Charlie the love and respect he deserves. Cherish your Charlie, Greg.
Brax is just hammering this tower with the Desolator. Like Splinter
is
Blast.
Is that a verb now?
Well, I said, what did I say?
You said hamming this tower.
I thought I meant to say hammering, but hamming, I guess.
I heard hamming. Rob, did you hear hamming? Rob heard hamming.
Ah, damn it.
Is that a chip?
What? I mispronounce a word. And I get a chip?
The commissioner.
Right, I guess we have like a million.
I mean, you've got a million chips. So don't argue with the commissioner. You'll have to put in two. Commissioner RMP has just decreed that will be a chip. As Cloud9 on the verge of punching their ticket to the Frankfurt Major here. They begin the siege on the high ground. Unknown looks so good coming into this match. 2-0-ing their Peruvian brothers, the Wolves. But C9 seem to have figured them out a bit. They take down the tower. They continue to press in, Sleight of Fisting through, almost finishing off the Wyvern off the bat. Ember will jump away, Clink's blinking out, and now sprinting. But the damage has been somewhat done, and this could be the item that turns the game. Very important for Unknown. They get a Hex finally on Queen of Pain, a reliable solution to lock down Ember, a counter to the Manted splitting out of an Orchid, and now they just need to make this debut a big pickoff. Ideally, you get a core here. I think most ideally the Ember. But they're going to jump on the top lane. 1437 pushed back by the Cox. He has the Ghost Scepter.
Oh, he
Soul
comes
Burn, not enough to bring him down. And he's right back to full health.
Ritsu is here. Clockwork does have the Aghanims, though, so Hookshot's up again.
Yeah, but needs a target to go to. Get me out of here. Help! And he hooks onto Brax. Pushes him back. Very nice escape by Ryo, but too bad. More heroes are waiting. Clink's blinking to the low ground. The stun's still going to follow him. And then desecrated by Brax and the gang. So they lose the Clinks. They also are going to lose Ryo.
No.
He's trapped
Why
on
is
no, he
still
hooks
here?
Away. Get me out of here. Doesn't seem like
he's
escaping.
Not
on the hunt,
he's
down
one.
To 200 HP after the stick, and Brax will corral him and finish him off. So we've yet to see the Quap Hex actually debut. It's just more kills piling in for Cloud9.
Feels like that should have been a fight that the Quap was at.
That was just so far away from their towers, though.
I guess, yeah.
I think those types of plays work when it's an even game, and you've got they're a little bit easier to kill. You have a little more damage, but...
Instead, Quap is just farming. Farming the enemy jungle. Bot lane getting pushed in, but on top lane, SVG is going to start putting down some wards and slowly chipping away. Very, very, very slowly. But look at... The other thing, look at... Brax has laid so many traps down on the map, and as a result, between traps and Venomancer wards, they have complete vision over the entire Dire Jungle for the moment. So that's going to make it so Ritsu and Brax can have a much easier time of picking someone off if they do see someone farming in the jungle. Plus, Steven is still camping out here.
See, now the Orchids are really becoming useless. Yeah, first, you've got the Ghost Scepter and Alk is a counter to the Klink's Orchid. You've got the Greaves to cleanse it on the Tusk, a double Manta style. This, to me, is why, unless you're really stomping, you just get the one on the hero that uses it the best, which is the Queen of Pain.
Solar Crest now for Theban as well, so it's going to make Clinks much less effective.
And, I mean, let's not even talk about MKB, because, God, he's so
He's,
far
like,
away
dreaming
from
of a world where MKB might exist in, like, 10 minutes, unless they win a couple
I'm
big fights.
I'm dreaming of an MKB, like the one
he's cliff jungling again.
To
that was beautiful. You,
thank you.
You a choir singer?
No, I'm terrible at singing.
Well, Ritsu's just going to keep farming. Nothing stopping him. He has a Chrysalis now. 9-0. Is Ritsu going to make it through this series without a death? LD, chip on the line.
Is Ritsu going to make it through the series without a death?
AKA, is he going to die in this game?
Because
he didn't die in the last game, right? I'm not an idiot. I don't think
he did. God damn it, Clink. Stop dying.
I didn't even see that one, to be honest with you.
Sometimes the GERD camera work slipping.
I can't catch them all, LD. This isn't Pokemon.
You want to sing the Pokemon song for the people, Greg?
Absolutely not. You've already done that on the BTS stream once, so no need for it to happen a second time.
No, you doing it, though, Greg. I'm sure you have a lovely voice. So will Ritsu die? I'm going to say... Oh, what is he going for here?
Daedalus.
What is the casual ultimate orb?
Lincoln Sphere.
No, I'm gonna say.
Yeah, I'm saying no too.
All right, so then
if he
dies, then we both put in a chip though.
All right, fine. We'll just
so we
the
still
same
lose
train.
A chip
yeah.
if we're wrong.
Yep, but
we're just not going against each other.
Yep,
we're rooting for Ritsu not to die.
Yep. I mean, I think if he finishes this Lincoln's, it's pretty unlikely that he will die. Well, I guess this could be a Scotty, but I don't really see the point.
Scotty's always decent.
I guess yeah. I guess it's never horrible, especially when you're this far ahead. It just makes you harder to kill. Gives you a little bit more damage.
And you apply
Plus
the
you get,
slow
yeah, you
to
get
everyone.
The slight massive mass slow or whatever.
I mean, they have ranged carries that aren't very easily kited, so... I mean, carry in air quotes at this point for the Clinks. Gigantic air quotes, Greg.
Yeah, cosplaying Clinks as a carry this game.
Well, 9, looking like a solid team that could potentially make a run at the major if they can close this
well.
One out.
And I was curious whether Cloud9 would kind of be like a flash in the pan or actually a consistently good team. And I have to say, after watching them play through this qualifier, I think they're going to be pretty consistently good. Charlie's back. Hey,
been
buddy.
Able to... I like how they've been able to change and...
Adapt
to different play styles. Before, they were pretty one-dimensional in the sense that they would play 4, protect 1 around Ritsu. Mm-hmm. But...
We're seeing different... Dress for sure. Now.
Yeah,
Brax has been stepping it up. Kind of makes that possible.
Yeah, and they've also like added in the you know the push strat, the just
the LD.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we made a bet while you were gone.
Okay.
Is Ritsu gonna die this game? Because he did not die in the last game, and currently he's 9-0.
And he's building a Lincoln.
And he's building a Lincoln Sphere. Is he gonna die this game?
We both said no.
We both said no.
Sure, I'll say yes. Just
okay. Okay. You know. Well, Lincoln Sphere is gonna be good against. Probably like what I would call the primary mechanic of unknown
it's the hex.
Turning.
The
I mean, yeah, the hex and then also the Winter's Curse.
Yeah, and there is a blink down the Wyvern, so. Yeah, you Commanta out of Orchid, but if you get hexed or cursed at the wrong position, you may die from full health. But
yep.
We're talking about dying. Ritsu doesn't know what that means. 9-0-10. So far, undefeated.
He's so efficient with his remnant usage and farming. Well, they hook in, but SVG 2 Savage has an Aghanim's now.
Okay.
Bought it himself. He has a 4 staff too. This Venno is more farm than the Clinks.
They found a DD rune. This may be cue to go high ground now as the Lincolns is complete.
Oh, C9. Yeah, it's time. Let's go.
Mid.
Let's go, boys. March up the hill.
20,000 gold lead. This is the classic timing to break the base. As they'll muscle down the range racks first. Ritsu with the big jump in. Sleight of fisting through.
God.
Messing up the Wyvern pretty damn bad. Now 1437 going to parade around, stun himself.
He has a Lotus Orb.
Is there to protect him. He gets hooked. Blade mail cogged back. But meanwhile, Brax going hard in the paint. Onto the Night Stalker. Executes him. And staying back is the Wyvern, looking for that good curse opportunity. Remnant forward, jumping on two. Ritsu going in like a man, and he's going to blow up Ryo as well. Gets the quick double, and now jumps away. Now the curse, only onto Brax, God. And it's with Ritsu going to work the whole while. Burns him down. GG, Cloud9 are going to Frankfurt. And North America will have some additional representation there. The Peruvians now drop down, and will have one last shot for redemption as they will take on Digital Chaos directly after this match.
I have to say, I think that Cloud9 in that game played some of the better Dota we've seen over like the last 4 days.
Yeah, absolutely.
In all regions.
They changed up their style. Yeah, it's very different.
I'm impressed, and we both won our bet. You lost.
Sure.
Put a blue chip in, Charles.
Or whatever color you're using.
He's just
sinking everyone else.
I mean, whatever. Jimmy already lost.
Wrecked this. Well, that's about it. I actually am curious if Kotaro had some significant lag that game because he quap ulted nothing like 3 to 4 times at least, and the other
no, it wasn't Kotaro. It was
Was Kotaro, wasn't it? Isn't he the bracket guy, or is that Dark Kanoa?
Dude, I don't know.
Dark Kanoa was the mid. I thought Kotaro was the safe planer.
See brackets.
Dakota said like 10 names. So.
If they wanted us to know their names, they should have just used them.
I think they need to put their players in more comfort here. I was like, the Clinks did not look comfortable.
He clearly had no idea what was going on in that game.
I thought everything else was okay. I would have liked to see a Midas out of the Night Stalker after the laning stage, but I think the biggest issue is just they obviously went on tilt. They kept on trying to make individual plays. Mm-hmm. They stopped organizing as a team. We saw like one smoke gank after the early laning stage, and
right. That's
just not how Unknown have been winning games. They've been winning games as a 5-man unit.
Mm-hmm. Well, we'll see if they have better success against Digital Chaos. After watching them in this series, I think Digital Chaos will probably beat them unless they have a change of heart
attitude
or something, because they did not play well.
I guess we'll really see. It'll be interesting to see how the playstyle of DC matches up against Unknown. I think one of the things that you have to that Digital Chaos really has to be mindful of is relax, don't feel too nervous, don't think too much about what other people think about you.
Yeah, because I'm sure if you do, like everyone was expecting Digital Chaos to just kind of waltz through this, so.
Right. I mean, don't expect the memes about, you know, second best NA team to really get to you. Play your own game, and just relax.
Yeah, I agree. Well, we'll be back in a couple of minutes for whenever the DC versus Unknown series begins.
Hopefully Unknown gives us a better showing. To me, if they play like they did yesterday, they are fully capable of dismantling Digital Chaos. DC also capable of just crushing them. This is very much down to just which team shows up for each.